Hi guys, this is my second cup of coffee today. I also don't know what's happening out in my hallway right now. How are you guys? I'm good. Christmas is over. Back to regular life. Overcaffeinated vlogs. I've had the weirdest day because I'm like going to work in about a half an hour, but I had a meeting this morning. So like I worked from 8 a.m. to 11 a.m. at a staff meeting, and then like I work again tonight from like 4 to 10. So I was like, I have 5 hours, I'm going home. So I went home and took a nap and watched some videos and stuff. What else did I do this week? I was very productive. I got like my oil changed and everything, and I like got checks and like deposited money like a grown-up. Doing grown-up things is a lot easier than I thought it was gonna be. I thought I had to like give the auto body shop like my year, make, model of my car. Nope. I just have to give them my first name and they're like, oh cool, appointment, got it, good. Honestly, I don't know why it was so complicated or why I thought it was so complicated, because it's not. I was on 4 hours of sleep today. I have been, not was, I have been on 4 hours of sleep. Also, I don't know if you can see. You see the Totoro? It says, try laughing, then whatever scares you will go away. It's like the opposite of a boggart. Because that's a thing. Just so you know, the way that I check to see if my camera's filming, I put a mirror behind it. Because I have no USB port on this thing that works, so I can't actually see what's in frame. I'm just guessing all the time. So that's my life. The rest of my week, I actually took a little day trip with my friend Holly to Snoqualmie Falls and then North Bend. And we had a little Twin Peaks trip, which was fun and adorable. And I didn't even realize that my cousin worked at the same place that like is the Great Northern. I'm like, what? If you're ever in the mood to have a Twin Peaks party, just go to the Salish Lodge in Snoqualmie Falls. Basically like on Snoqualmie Falls. So we went and hiked and it was really foggy. And then we got back to Seattle. We went to Discovery Park, which is where like The Killing was supposed to take place the first two seasons. Speaking of The Killing, finished season 3. Haven't started season 4 yet, but holy shit. That's a thing. So I went and did a Twin Peaks thing. I posted some pictures on my Flickr that I'll put a link to below. That was really fun, actually. Like, it was really fun. I was like, my coworker, she texted me and she's like, hey, do you want to go to Snoqualmie Falls and take pictures this week? I was like, yeah, dude. Yeah, I do. And so she took her film camera. She used a couple rolls. I took my digital because I haven't figured out my film cameras yet. I need to do that. But it was really cool. And it was really like laid back, and it was like my day off and it was fun. Oh, Twin Peaks, man. I'm on episode like 9. Yeah. Netflix. I saw Builders and the Butchers on Friday. My fucking boss's band, Keaton Collective, that's a band you should check out if you're from Seattle or the internet in general. They opened for Builders and the Butchers at the Sunset Tavern. And it was the first time I'd seen Builders and the Butchers for like 3 years, because I saw them last at like Music Fest Northwest in fucking Portland in like 2011. And I was really excited to see them. And they played a cover of I Put a Spell on You, which was glorious. Like, I Put a Spell on You as their like gothic folk Whiskey Devil music. Thank Laurel for that. I was hoping she would just walk in. I don't know why I expect people just like walk through my door and be like, welcome, because it's like a fucking TV show. No, it's not. Nope. So went to Twin Peaks, saw some bands, bought some records. Still not going to do my whole record collection video, but I'll do like a haul because I bought some records and some CDs. So I bought Typhoon's White Lighter on vinyl because I needed to own it. I needed to own it in every form. I don't have it on like cassette tape though. That'd be kind of unnecessary, I feel like. But I installed my record player. I'll insert a clip of it here. It's pretty, I like it. And then I also bought the Decemberists' The Crane Wife, which is probably my favorite Decemberists album. I mean, I always like Hazards of Love and picaresque. I don't know how it's fucking supposed to be said. So yeah, I bought some records and I bought some CDs. And actually, I want to put out an APB for anybody out there who shops at record stores. If you ever come across this album on vinyl, Menomina's Friend and Foe, it was from like 2006. It's one of my favorite albums of all time, definitely in the top five. If you ever find it on vinyl, buy it for me and I will pay you back by like in money, cash money, and then in like favors and thank yous and all of the treats, because I want to own that record on record so bad. It was the first album I owned by Menomina. Pretty sure it was the first album I listened to high, and I just love Menomina. Just saying. If you're wondering, I'm wearing this color on my lips right now. It's Lush's Motivation. Technically an eyeliner, but I don't give a fuck. So, what else have I purchased recently? I haven't really gone like thrifting or like clothes shopping. I bought a couple things from like, this was from Hot Topic. And then from like Topshop, I bought a couple shirts. I've been looking for this like denim dress too. It's a pain in my soul. So I went to Topshop and I tried on this like really great denim jumper that was very much like Clarissa explains it all type thing. One day I was like, do I need this? I don't know. If I come back tomorrow and it's here, I'll get it. Went back the next day. They had sold my size, but they had a 6 and they had a 12. And I was like, fucking A, I could fit into an 8 or a 10, but they don't have those sizes. They literally had a 4, a 6, a 12, and like a 16. And I was like, heyo, you're not in frame yet. You need to make sure now you're in frame. Are you going to work? No, you're not going to find a work.
I don't have a job yet.
You're going to find a job.
I'm going to the coffee shop to hang out.
She's dancing. She's like, too bad my fucking lens doesn't go all the way in my door, because you could like moonwalk out the door.
I could.
Damn it.
I can't.
I need like an extra wide angle lens. This doesn't work. That's Laurel. At our meeting today at work, we actually get to try the new Valentine's Day stuff. Probably by the time this video is going up though, Valentine's things are probably in stores at Lush, so you should go buy it all. But I did buy some of the new massage bars. They came out like a month and a half ago. I got Percut, which is a coffee scented one, because those are fucking coffee beans. Actual coffee beans, guys. Now I have like 9 massage bars. Did I include these in my Lush stash? I feel like I might have. I don't know. Oh well, I'll talk about them again. I don't really care. I bought them recently. And then Shades of Earl Grey, which is glorious and would go wonderful with the grass. Shower gel.
That sounds nice.
I know I have several of you that watch my channel that live in and around Seattle. There's at least several of you. And I would like to hang out with you guys at some point. I don't live far from downtown and I would love to have a little bit of a meetup thing. Just maybe just to hang out, go to Pike Place, just chill, do some fun stuff, maybe go to Ballard. I don't care. But let me know what days generally work for you guys, because I mean, I follow a bunch of you guys and I would love to like hang out and stuff and do things. Cause that could be fun. I don't know, maybe I could get like a special guest or something. Also, there's a show coming up next month that you should go to. I'm gonna pull it up on Facebook. Next month, in Tacoma, actually, February 7th, it is a Saturday at Urban Grace Church in downtown Tacoma. Ravenna Woods is doing a show. They're playing a show, but there's also going to be like choreographed dancers to go along with it. And it's going to be this really like cool, epic whole performance piece. And it's going to be fucking beautiful, because like A, beautiful people, all the guys in Ravenna, like I love them. And then like dance, which is cool. Like you don't normally see that at a show. So if you're like within 30 miles of Tacoma, you should come to that show, because it'll be super cool. I'll post a link to the Facebook event page in the description. There's gonna be all sorts of links in the description. Links to my Flickr pictures, links to Builders and the Butchers pictures, and then to event pages and stuff. But yeah, totally let me know what days are generally good for you guys. And if you'd want to go like downtown or in Ballard, Sunday is usually a good day. I can get those days easily off of work, and parking is free downtown if you need to park. If you take the bus, it's no issue. But Sundays are usually good days, or like weekdays. I don't know if you guys are in school still. If you're not, then any day. But if you are, let me know what days are better for you. Song of the day is Black Elevator by Builders and the Butchers, and this was a song off their 2011 album Dead Reckoning, which I haven't listened to in a long ass time because I lost that album. I had it, but I lost it, so I have to like re-download it and shit. But it's a really great record, and it's a really great song, and they played it at the show, and it was really good. What up, caffeine? It's all finished. I should have stirred up my coffee better. It's just like, what's happening out in the hallway right now?
Songs.
Songs?
Declarations of love.
Okay.
I love everyone. Cool.
Everybody loves everyone, apparently. What was this video? Honestly, I was like, I need to record a video because I gotta go to work and I don't have any ideas. And also I'm running out of 4 hours of sleep and 2 cups of coffee. It's logical that I make an overcaffeinated video because when I'm like at the point where my brain is like, nothing's working, that's usually what I do. Cool. I should go. I'm just gonna go.